Today, let's take a look at the Mackie Mix8 mixer for podcasting. All right, continuing in the line of my sub $100 mixer shootout, the Mackie Mix8 comes in underneath the Mackie VLZ series, which has the Onyx preamps. So the first thing to take note of on this Mackie mixer is that it does not have the Onyx preamps, which are the higher end preamps that Mackie puts out. So if you've been following along, you know, for me, the main thing for all of these mixers is how is the preamp, you know, the trim, the gain, when you put it up at the top here, how does it sound so that it can push any microphone you plug into it, assuming that, you know, in this case, 50 dB plus 50 dB is enough gain for the microphone that you're using. In my case, in the samples you'll hear linked in the description, along with all the gear that you'll see there, I was using an ATR2100 in those samples. And that is typically a gain-hungry mic. It's a dynamic mic, but the 50 dB was enough to power the ATR2100, and it powered it cleanly. That's the key. This preamp in this mix series, again, not being Onyx, still sounds amazing. In fact, I'm quite surprised that the plus 50 dB versus the plus 60 dB that you get on the Onyx series, that's 10 dB more, critical 10 dB at the top there, but I don't hear much difference. And it seems like the VLZ or the Onyx preamp takes all of this, almost all of the 60 dB, and this takes almost all the 50 dB, and I get the levels that I want, which are, you know, around zero on my meters here. So the key is that when I crank up this preamp to its max, it produces a nice sound, quite nice, actually. I'm surprised. I thought that when I got this mixer, because it is more affordable than the VLZ series, because it doesn't have those Onyx preamps and a couple other things it doesn't have, I thought, well, this might be just too cheap, but Mackie has put in really good preamps, and that is what the company should do, right? Just because it's not their top preamp, it doesn't mean that the next one shouldn't sound any good. So again, it sounds great. For me, we can move on from there, because if it didn't sound good there, I wouldn't move on with the review. It would just be a pretty much a bad mixer and be out of the, it would be out of the lineup. I've actually liked three of the four mixers I like a lot in this sub 100 mixer shootout. I guess let me explain what some of the big differences are that make this more affordable. Starting off with the build quality, whereas the VLZ series, it's made out of steel. This is like an aluminum, it feels like. So the materials are a little different, not quite as sturdy. However, this thing still feels really sturdy. And look at the profile, look how flat this thing is. You could really just slip this thing into a backpack and go. Compared to the VLZ, this has the same knobs, so they feel really great. I'm not sure if they're sealed like the VLZ, but what you gain here is some extra features, which I'll talk about in a second, but also different is the LED meter. It's about half of what you get on the VLZ, meaning you can't tell exactly where I am on the audio meter scale here, as well as I can tell on the VLZ. So that's cut down. They save some money on LEDs. I don't know, but that's not as big. It goes from minus 20 to zero. You can't see where you are in between that, but not a big limitation. It's just, it's nicer to see more indicators of where your audio is. No power switch. This is kind of a big one. It's nice to have a power switch. The VLZ4 has that. This does not, so you have to plug it in and unplug it when you want to turn it on and off. So I do really like having that power switch. It doesn't have the microphone stand mount that the VLZ has in it. That's a little extra feature, not something that I would necessarily use, but it's not on this one. The plug is only this one prong plug versus the nice lockable. It's got the three pronged balanced plug there. This one is just a simple little plug. I don't know if that would cause any issues with grounding, but it's just not as, it's not as well built. And I do like the lockable on the model up of the VLZ series. What you do get is a big thing that you get for less than $100 that you don't get on the VLZ series is you get the aux send. And the aux send channel is what allows you to do a mix minus if you're gonna do like interviews via Skype or Google Hangout or something, you can do that with this mixer. So if that is something you need to do or you want to do with your podcast, you need an aux send for that mix minus setup, then the Mix Series can get you into an aux send for less than $100. So that's just gonna be a determination of how you're producing your podcast. Do you need it or do you not need that extra channel? And of course you get an extra stereo channel, but other than that, you get all the other stuff. Each channel here has pan knobs on it, and you've got your overload light, so you can set your levels properly. Or you can use, of course, the regular LED, as I've shown in my other video, on how to set up this gain stage, this mixer, so it sounds its best. This is not a USB mixer, it's all analog out, so you've got the aux send again, you've got a control room out, and some mains to come out of there, so a couple different options to come out, including the tape out, the RCA. So plenty of options to get audio out of this. You've got your one headphone jack with an adjustable volume knob for your headphones, and of course it supplies 48 volts phantom power. For me, this has worked fantastic. I've done an aux send setup, a mix minus setup, sounded great. The key is I've plugged in both my microphones, cranked up the gains, and it sounds completely clean. And I would get this mixer if this had the features and the stuff that I wanted on it. I like the VLZ a little bit more, but it doesn't have that aux send. So if you need that and you still wanna stay under $100, then the Mix8 is probably the choice for you. Of course, we have one more mixer in the Sub 100 mixer shootout, the Behringer, which I also like. So you wanna take a look at that one as well. But this is the Mackie Mix8 8-channel compact mixer. It's definitely slim. It's got a low profile, fairly compact, fits in your bag, and I like it. Clean preamps. All right, I'll see you next time.